And in the Abyss, Demon Spawn of Ashton Sari. We got a brand new weapon from a Ziggurat. And so we are deeper into the Abyss. Hey, there's a portal to go deeper right there. And against the Star Cursed Masses, I can say having this Locabur axe is going to be nice. Maybe it's the Low Chabert. I don't know. Haven't fought a Starflower before. This is like the first character I'm like, these open diamond rooms are actually the rooms that I prefer to be in. There's some items or something down in here. Chaos clouds. Side there, staff of cold, ring of ice, and a plus 10 quarter staff. That's exciting. Alright, so we're on Abyss 3. Vision of a gate. Well, you want a vision of a moon. That's what I want. So, we can see that this AoE cleave really quite powerful. Alright, so we ended up on Abyss 4. Get ourselves tormented by a lurking horror, which kind of sucks. Alright, so we detect the rune. Where do we detect the rune? There it is. Down beneath us. Alright. Alright, company, let's do this. Ranged combat and elements. It's not what we want. Alright, so we have to get in on the other side. And whatever's on the other side is, of course, going to be difficult and annoying to kill. But that's okay. No chance. We should probably use a potion of resistance. Let's get slay. Don't have much resist. Just try to not take a lot of damage. Famous last words? Is that what those are? It's also holy and vulnerable to holy damage. Alright, let's hope we don't get yanked away. Of course, as soon as we said that, we get yanked away. That's how it works. One-on-one with the Juggernaut. That was successful. We see a gateway leading out at our feet. Grab the rune. And let's get out of the abyss. Alright, we've got a pretty solid 5-rune game. Be respectable. Kind of feels like we ought to do Pandemonium now. And at least get one of them. If we really are going to do the rest of the game, we probably ought to put a lot of points into Necromancy and go for Necromutation. I think that'll probably be... That could very well be what we do, at least. Alright, so we've got some stuff to think about for our character. You know, whether we even bother to go for necromutation, which isn't anywhere close to being castable. We'd basically have to take necromancy and transmutations each up to 15. But we could get that far in Pandemonium. Might have to clear Zaun. And maybe that's just what we tell ourselves. Maybe we say, let's go clear Zaun. And let's get your pole arms where it needs to be. And then we'll see if there's enough experience to get necromancy. I think that's probably a good thing to do. I know a lot of recommendations to not do Zaun until the very end, because of how difficult Zaun is, and although I'm inclined to agree, the thing about Pandemonium is that it's just different. At least in Zaun, you have staircases and stuff. So it's overall much more familiar. I think it's easier to comprehend from a playstyle perspective. So that's going to be our tentative plan. Get our Locomotor Axe up. And if we get a good curse on it, we probably won't have to worry about the weapon skill. But we're going to get the polearm skill. And then we'll worry about the necromancy and transmutations and stuff. So, we're going to take ourselves a break. Thanks for watching. For readings and salutations, we're back as a maximum level. Demon Spawn Gladiator of Ashen, sorry. We are right now training our pole arms to minimum attack delay. Meanwhile, we're using a manual of transmutations, and we are going to try and get ourselves necromutation, but we need some experience for that. We have gotten 5 runes already, five easy ones, you could say. I'm not sure you want to call the slime pits easy, but there you have it. We do miss our little spectral weapon. It really is a good brand. But this weapon is going to be even better for us, so that's why we have it. Have a good curse, we've ranged weapon. All right, let's go ahead and use ignition, and then we can kill everything all around us. Heck yeah. That's what we're talking about. Alright, so ignition does kill the freezing clouds, kind of unsurprisingly. It's about what we would expect. Oh, it's not a ranged vault. It is a teleporter, so we'll go through. Nice, scrolls of poison. We have some sort of boots down here. What are these? 10 dexterity? Seriously, 10 dexterity. But you lose resist fire. We're probably going to have a tough time with that orb of fire. I'm probably going to need to consider putting on a potion of resistance. Melee combat and ranged combat. The throwing. The throwing could perhaps be useful, but let's just hold out a little longer. Okay, so these folks are all berserk now. And we are slow. So we need to do something about that. We probably could have used Galupria or something like that. We're gonna read a teleport scroll. And then we're gonna cast Ignition. Looks like we miscast Ignition. Ooh. That's a little scary. Let's turn on Wereblood. Is that Orb of Fire? Let's run away from the Orb of Fire. And well, why the heck not? Phantom Mirror, we feel less energetic, minus 10% MP. Lame. Well, realistically, that wasn't that much HP. I mean, mana points. It's still a doable amount. Alright, getting close to maxing out our pole arm for Mindelay. Two golden dragons. Wow, would you look at that. Look at this huge gold ball. We're getting hundreds of gold in here. Nice. We'll take it. What's on slot 3? Companions in melee. Does that also give us necromancy? Why, yes it does. Let's go ahead and get that. So, let's go ahead and get 27 on the pole arms. Let's do the same with fighting. And then necromancy and transmutations will bring it up. Okay, there's that orb of fire. Let's go ahead and use a phantom mirror. Alright, we got ourselves -1 strength, but 4 dexterity. So that's not too bad. Let's get some freezing clouds in there. Along with rare blood. Sure, we'll cast Mantle of the Sun. Alright. Freezing cloud works pretty well. We're lucky to have a good combo. Getting ourselves pretty heavily drained now, which is a little annoying. All right, getting some experience. Because we're Ashen Zari, even though. Yeah, we've just gotten a lot of bonus experience, basically. Because we're effectively maxed out on fighting, spellcasting, pole arms. So right now, it's going to be very, very easy for us to get the necromancy and transmutations that we're after. We only have 4 spell levels, which isn't great, but hey, necromutation's already at 65%. So we're gonna have to forget something that's level 4 We could probably forget, Omen and Prism, perhaps. Everything else kind of has its own niche. Ulgrib's Toxic Radiance, we probably don't need anymore. It's probably not going to be in use. But then once we get Necromutation up, we're probably going to want to get some more onto dodging, evocations and companion. It wouldn't be too bad. Kind of because we already have introspection maxed out. We already have melee maxed out. Necromancy and summoning isn't so bad. It would be really, really nice to get companions and beguiling, though. And so let's hold off on that. We're just making our progress through Zot 3. Killing basically everything here. Alright, let's go to Zot 4. Well, we may as well do some ignition here. All the enemies that are adjacent to one another will easily die. Let's not wander into that whole thing in the middle just yet. See if we can clear the perimeter. Apologies in advance if we end up sneezing or coughing. We're really trying to mute ourselves before it gets that bad. Alright, it's condenser vein. Unfortunately, we get the shit electric. But our mana regens really quickly when we need it to. Plus, we cleave everything. And when our mana is low, our health regen gets transferred to magic, which is pretty insane. Oh, alchemy and beguiling? Transmutations. Conjurations and translocations. That could be good. Let's just get it. Alright, so we're fully maxed out. to enable at least one skill. Yes. Necromutations at 16%, dog. So let's get transmutations up to 18. And let's get necromancy up to 15. And we'll focus necromancy. And we'll try and get that a little closer. Alright, looks like we've got it basically around the perimeter. So it's about time to go to the inside, where we're going to find a lot of scary things. Hey! Hooray for scary things. Now, where's the entrance? Here it is. Okay. So this is the final vault, so to speak. Zop 4 that opens up into Zop 5. Make liberal use of manifold assault at distance. The cleaving is super nice. And no other enemies can enter unless it's through this opening. So we feel pretty good about that. Alright, again, this is our only opening. So, just cleave everything. And let's go ahead and forget Permanent Prism. It is a nice spell, but we're gonna get Necromutation. Memorization got interrupted, so we'll memorize it after we kill these draconians, I suppose. Alright, let me try one more time. So, if we turn into a lich, we keep all of our equipment. We get lots of resist negativity, immunity to torment, but we cannot drink any of our potions. How's our regen? Our regen is just the same. We're already vulnerable to holy. Necromancy enhancer, mutation immunity. Fire, Ancient Lich. We can focus the Orb of Fire and still damage everything else around us. Nice. Nice. And we do the Necromancy Enhancer. 7% is pretty good. So let's get that to 18. Necromancy, let's get to 16. Armor, let's get to 11. Dodging, let's get to 17. Throne, let's get to 10. And stealth, why not? Let's get a little stealth. Well, we did accomplish what we set out to do, which was get Necromutation online. We could go and clear Zot. Zot can be difficult, but sure. So weird, we have this lava entrance in Zot 5 that kind of goes right up to the entrance. I've never seen that. We have an extremely small Zot 5. Stepping on a dispersal trap is not really interesting at the moment. So let's see what the other side has. Other side looks wide open. Red Lich and Ancient Lich, well, we can go Necromutation. Alright, one of them has seen us. So we beckon them over. Seen us, we beckon them over. you just barely missed that Malmutate. Alright, this is pretty bad. Oh, and we can't drink potions, of course. Duh, what were we thinking? Let's torment. Wow, that didn't have the result we were hoping for. Alright, we're not slow anymore. So we can't cast Wereblood, and we can't go into other transformations. Interesting. Yeah, it is a little tempting to just grab the orb right now. But we would like to get more than 5. Okay, that's probably good enough for now. So now that we've cleared all these things, we could go to the Hall of Blades, but I think that's just asking for problems. And we could probably take it. Let's just do it. Let's just see what we miss. What did we miss in the Hall of Blades? Can manifold salt all these people, all these from a distance. Yeah, we just have to wait a tiny bit. Not really a whole lot else we can put our points into. Zenata? I don't think we've ever seen Zenata before. Okay, so they do a lot of damage. We can see that now. So let's start with a freezing cloud. And then we'll manifold assault. Right, it's ignition. Nice. That actually worked. I was kind of afraid it wouldn't work because it was a crap ton of enemies. And really at risk of getting swarmed and overwhelmed. There's that. Yeah, that badass. Executioner's axe. It's not better than what we have, but it looks cool. Alright, so that finishes the Hall of Blades. You know, I guess the next thing to do, we could try and clear out Hell. Is it worth a haste? It's at least worth Necromutation. Alright, let's go down and see. So that's a gateway back. Let's do that. And then we'll manifold assault. And then we'll just tab. We are necromutated. Could Starburst? That seems to be doing a lot of damage, actually. Alright, cool. These putrid mouths. The asthma breath and warning cry. Seems a little dangerous. Just like being constrained, just like being marked. Well, everything knows that we're down there now. So I guess we'll just ignition everything, and then we'll kill whatever isn't fire immune here at the moment. Let's go ahead and read one of those scrolls of poison. Alright, let's ignite it. So we're talking about fellas. Fire. and brimstone. Lots of fire. Ludicrous amounts of fire. That's what we're in search of. Let's go upstairs. Oh, we've been muted for a long time. But that's what we get. Coughing and sneezing. Trying not to have an open mic. So, again, we're really just gonna try and come in here and smash. There's no reason to spend an over much amount of time at each branch. We actually don't see a downstairs. Maybe we'll see one as we explore a little more. Elemental Wellspring. Use Lesser Beckoning. Get them right next to us. They blinked away. We'll get them right next to us. That's what we're talking about. There's another wellspring down there. Let's go ahead and use ignition. At the very least, that'll make some smoke. Let's try to break line of sight from where that wellspring is. We can still hit multiple things right now. Alright, so we're looking good on mana. We have this Nargoon over here. Alright, let's ignition him. It'll probably take him out. Alright, cool. Kakadus Fire. This is scary. We get three Shard Shrikes, Elemental. We're just gonna ignition a bunch. And hope that that will kill what we need it to kill. And wouldn't you know, it kind of looks like it. Kind of looks like it. Nice, 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 nice. Throwing. Let's get up a little higher. Evocations. Let's get that to 20. Dodging. Just get to 25. Armor. Let's get to 15. Let's see what that does, if anything. Transformation's almost over, so let's extend it. Still have yet to see any downstairs. There it is. How many levels of Cocytus are there? Seven? Okay. Cocytus six. We will take out the Hellion, and then we'll just ignition for a little while. So this may be where we have to bail. And there's certainly nothing wrong with family. We have two of these wellsprings. Wow, looks like we actually got them. But there's more. And they're not right next to each other. Okay, there's a lot more. Wait a turn, but it doesn't seem likely that we're going to be able to get them all. Alright, we're running away. That was pretty successful, though. We got almost all the way to the 7th level. And there's wellsprings. Yeah, there's going to be more and more enemies every time. There's no such thing as a clear, and they're just going to keep respawning. But we'll get a little deeper. Necromutation makes a big difference. Alright, Cocytus 7 it is. Let's use one of our scrolls of magic mapping. So we get this nice big island. We can start off with some Manifold Assault. And we're particularly going to try and focus this Shard Strike. I think this might be a good place to take a break and start fresh the next time we stream, and we'll try and get our ice rune, the icy rune of Zot. So thanks for watching, we'll be back tomorrow. Greetings and salutations. We are here as a maximum level demon spawn at Ashen Zari. We are a phalangite. We use our maximum skills pole arms. Right now we're at the very end, the bottom of the icy hell, Cocytus. It's not how you say it, sorry. I've only ever seen it red. And the closest word I can think of is Cocytus. It's not spelled exactly the same. Anyhow, we have ourselves a bunch of spells. And we don't have any free spell levels. So if we get any other spell, we're going to have to cut it from somewhere else. So we do have Borknures, we have Fireball, Ball Lightning, We have Dragon and Storm Form. Dispersal. We have Haunt. Azakubu's Refrigeration. We have Infestation. And with a little bit more experience, we can get Lehudib's Crystal Spear, Summon Horrible Things, Dragon's Call. That would be a lot. A lot more summoning. So those are possibly options for us to consider. We're pretty happy with our spell loadout. Potentially we could drop Lee's Rapid Deconstruction. Potentially we could drop Summon Forest. Potentially we could drop Statue Form. That's actually not a bad idea to drop Statue Form. Give us anything good, we could get Blink, which is good. Ordinars. Well, whatever. We are going to start making our way. And we're making heavy use of Manifold Assault. It probably wouldn't be a bad idea to get some more translocation and then, you know, we could get Malign Gateway, I guess. Dispersal. How useful could that be? That's something that probably could be good, actually. So we have permanent fly, which means we could just chill out over this heavy water. Shard Strike. Not who we want to be up against. We do an okay job taking him out. There's another. Having like super awesome resist is pretty convenient. Yeah, we have to be careful about paying attention to an offer. Lich Form runs out. Go ahead and use Ignition. Seems to work pretty well. Packs of enemies that are adjacent to one another. You don't have to be super afraid of the Ice Fiend when we're in Lich Form, but we're in Lich Form, it's pretty bad news if we're not in Lich Form. Okay, so this is an example of us going way too far. So, there we go. We could. How much damage do we do with Starburst? 6d13. Probably do more damage just hitting them with their Locomotive X, because we hit all four of them. This is a good opportunity for Starburst. Alright, get closer to yourself so we can use ignition. So we have a pretty baller weapon. We've been blessed to have baller weapons for basically the entire game. We've always seen this weapon a few times, and we're like, oh man, it would be awesome to use this weapon. So we're just kind of clearing the area immediately in front. Okay, so the Hellion can't fly. Take out this Etten simulacrum. Right, we probably cleared enough. Yeah, all sorts of bad things. Look what this thing in red is. That thing in red is Antaeus. It makes 682 HP. Got rid of our Curare too. Is there a back? Yeah, there's no back. Can we dig it? Nope. So we have to come through the front, and that's exactly where Antaeus is. Probably want to haste and mine ourselves and then go into the witch farm. We probably want a potion of resistance. How many of those do we have? It's enough for each. Kind of scary. We definitely don't want Antaeus to come out here. Don't be sure there's no back entrance. Dang. Alright, well, that's how it is. Let's try and pull some of these enemies so that we are more likely to fight Antaeus one by one. Alright, let's do it. Let's end our transformation. Oh, we can't drink potions. Because we're in hell. Okay, well, changes things. Susceptible to fire. We cast fire a whole bunch. We can start with fire burst, starburst, whatever it's called. What's actually cast a meth cloud? Let's ignite that with poison, and then we'll do some starburst. Looks like it's not really working. Alright, let's get a phantom mirror. And let's get a box of beasts. Standing on fire, it's a good thing. Box of beasts is dead. Almost dead, huh? Let's read a scroll of summoning. It's basically worthless. Oh, that was so close. Not as close as the cigarette. Let's go in and get that rune before it gets worse. Boom, icy rune. Enchant weapon, enchant armor. I don't think they were ever going to use those, honestly. But we'll get the treasure anyway. Lots of mutation potions, blink scroll. Alright. There is some more gold back here. We have to kill a lot of enemies to get it. It's roughly 100 gold. A little more. I don't think we really need the gold. Okay, well, let's get out of here. Alright, one room down. So, probably the next easiest, maybe you can call them easy, would be to get the dark room. So, there's Dis, and then there's also Tartarus. It saps your willpower. Well, that's not good. But what do you think? You check it out? Let's check it out. So, Doomhounds, we gotta get rid of those, like, as soon as possible. Those are, like, the worst possible enemy that we could fight. So we're gonna charm them. Then we're gonna wait until they get closer. So we do get the... Oh, they changed the name of these. Oh, no, they didn't. Instead of Mittle... There's a different name for the pluralization. They have Dispel Undead. That's pretty bad. Like, for real. Let's go ahead and kill this Doomhound. Hope we don't get Doom. We have half willpower. Go ahead and get that Doomhound. We do get the Howl status. Let's wait until the Doomhound is dead. Now we can cancel it. Which cancellation do we have for? There would be more dangerous times, I suppose. Alright, we're not Howled anymore. Alright, which one it is? We take out a Putrid Mouth. We'll use Meth Cloud and Night Poison for cheapo Fire Clouds. Firestorm would be nice. We are currently silenced. And what are we doing exploring around? I mean, we're lich, so no big deal, but what are we doing exploring around? Tartarus 2. So that's a little scary. We can hit almost all of them, though. So that's what we're gonna do. Just gonna melee them all. And that'll be pretty effective. Alright, we got some bone dragons. Alright, come on in, step into the fire. Small levels. Being silenced is not really what we want. Please don't tell us the stairs are all the way in there. Let's do the Silent Spectre. A lot of magic mapping, so where's our stair? Okay, yep. all the way down there in the corner. Can we dig this? Damn. Manifold assault, try and attack at outside of the science. Oh shit, we're marked. How did we not notice them? The good news is that we'll be able to take out the Silent Spectre. Okay, so let's just keep on going. Tartarus 3. First thing we see is a Tsitsimidol. Tsitsimidol. Staircases here. But at least there's no silence. But... Tainted Leviathan. Never seen one of these. Doomhounds, yikes. Whoa. Dispersal trap, huh? Another dispersal trap. Alright, well, whatever. We'll attack what's in front of us, sure. Alright, still looking for the staircase. There it is. Alright, Tartarus 4. Lots of stuff around here. Are these Leviathans immune to fire? The cones are, though? No. They're even resistant to fire. Okay. We might have to bail on this. What was that? Okay, let's bail. You can always use your no penalty and just come back. It's no big deal. Alright. Alright, we're now back on Tartarus 3. Let's go to Tartarus 4. And we're right back where we were. No worries. Yeah, you can't put me ice man if there's already a cloud there. Let's get up to Tarptaurus. Alright. 50 max HP drain, which is not great. We got Howl, which is not great. We're pretty late in the game, so Howl's not so bad. But normally Howl is like super not good. Definitely don't want to see Howl in the rest of the game. Alright, so that's not the correct way. Well, held again. Alright, let's charm it. Tell it to go attack other stuff. I think charming works really well on those two hounds. Still getting evocation, right? Good. Let's get some stealth too, because why not? Alright, Tartarus 6. Another Silent Spectre. Not really what we want to see. Let's see how far over we can go until we have to be silenced. We can ponder on this, and we'll be right back. Thanks for watching. has an update. We actually are gonna take ourselves a break. So if you just joined, sorry, but thanks for watching.